Welcome to this YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to talk about top 10 kings of Iran. So before starting this video, please like this video, and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. In the classical period, there were many kings of Persia, but few were ever as powerful as the Achaemenids. The kings of Persia were able to draw on enormous resources from all across this vast empire and exert influence far beyond their borders. Arranged chronologically, these are the 12 men who held the title, King of Persia, from the founding of the Achaemenid Empire to its destruction at the hands of Alexander the Great. First, we should know about Artaxerxes V, who, unlike the other kings of Persia, Artaxerxes was a self-proclaimed leader. Darius III was stabbed and left dying on the road. Also, Darius III, who was last of the official kings of Persia, Darius was originally from a slightly more junior branch of the Achaemenid royal family, and went by the name Artashada. Prior to becoming king of Persia, he had distinguished himself in a combat of champions, served as a royal courier, was appointed satrap of Armenia, oversaw the entire Achaemenid postal system, and became of the king's friends at court. Following the murders of Artaxerxes III and IV, Artashada was made king of Persia and adopted the name Darius III. Number 10. Artaxerxes IV, R. 338-336 BC. Arsaca, or in Greek Asses, was the youngest son of Artaxerxes III, and his wife Atossa, and as such was not expected to ascend the throne. Under the guidance of Artaxerxes III, the Achaemenid Empire had been experiencing a general revival of fortunes, as it was reorganized and various revolts were suppressed. Much of this was thanks to the efforts of the eunuch Bagoas, who rose to the position of vizier and was the real power behind the throne. When Bagoas fell out of favor with Artaxerxes III, he conspired with the royal physician to poison the king of Persia and most of his family. Number 9. Artaxerxes III, R. 358-338 BC. Ochus was a younger son of Artaxerxes II and satrap of Phoenicia, who ascended the throne as Artaxerxes III largely because his older brothers had all been eliminated in various plots. To secure his position as king of Persia, Artaxerxes III soon executed around 80 of his family members. Most of Artaxerxes III's reign was spent dealing with rebellions across his empire. After making peace with Athens, he attempted to disband the powerful satrapel armies of the Anatolian satraps. The ensuing revolt took 2 years to put down. Artaxerxes III then turned his attention to the reconquest of Egypt but was defeated. This massive defeat led to revolts in Anatolia, Phoenicia, and Cyprus. Number 8. Artaxerxes II, R. 404-358 BC. Shortly after the death of his father Arsaces, now as king of Persia, Artaxerxes II faced a rebellion led by his younger brother Cyrus, who had risen to great fame while campaigning in Asia Minor. Cyrus led a large army bolstered by 10,000 Greek mercenaries, including the historian Xenophon, who left an account of the expedition, against his brother. The king of Persia, despite initially hoping to resolve the conflict peacefully, emerged victorious. Cyrus' rebellion left Artaxerxes II too weak to directly confront the Spartan king Agesilaus II's invasion, 396-387 BC, forcing him to instead subsidize their enemies in mainland Greece. Number 7. Darius II, R. 424-404 BC. Following the death of Artaxerxes I, his son Artaxerxes became Xerxes II, king of Persia, but only ruled for 45 days and was only recognized as king in Persia. He was murdered by his brother Sogdianus, who in turn was murdered by his illegitimate half-brother Ochus, after a reign of roughly 6 months over a territory that consisted of little beyond Persia and Elam. Ochus had been the satrap of Hyrcania, and after killing his brother Arsites, who had attempted to emulate his example, took for himself the name Darius II, king of Persia. Number 6. Artaxerxes I, R. 465-424 BC. Asses was the third son of Xerxes I and became king of Persia, following the death of his father at the hands of Artabanus. Depending on the source, Xerxes I's eldest son Darius was killed either by Artabanus or Asses. After ascending the throne as Artaxerxes I, he was faced with a major revolt in Egypt, 460-454 BC, which was led by a Libyan prince and had Athenian assistance. Artaxerxes I inherited a war with the Greeks, which had been fought to a standstill. Unable to make much headway militarily, he began the practice of providing funds to play each Greek state off against each other. This practice helped to motivate the Athenians to relocate the treasury of the Delian League to Athens. By 449 BC, Artaxerxes was able to conclude the Peace of Colias with Athens and Argos, ending the war that began under his father. Number 5. Xerxes I, R. 485-465 BC. The son of Darius I and Atossa, the daughter of Cyrus, Xerxes was named as his father's successor prior to an expedition against rebels in Egypt. Though not the eldest son of Darius I, he ascended the throne as king of Persia on the basis of his mother's lineage, and the fact that he was the first son born to Darius I after Darius I had become the king. After becoming king of Persia, Xerxes I ruthlessly suppressed revolts in Egypt and Babylonia before turning his attention to Greece. Xerxes I spent 3 years gathering supplies and soldiers from across his empire, while also preparing roads and canals to assist the passage of his army. After brief delays and the loss of part of his fleet at Thermopylae and Artemisium, Xerxes I was able to capture and burn Athens. Number 4. Darius I the Great, R. 522-486 BC. Darius I was the eldest son of Hystaspes, satrap of Bactria, and rose to become the personal spear-bearer of Cambyses II. Originally from a much junior branch of the Achaemenids, the story of Darius I's rise to power is hazy at best. After the death of Cambyses II, Bardia or the Magi Gamata became king of Persia, but was assassinated by Darius I and his six companions. Following his ascension to the throne, Darius I faced revolts across the empire in Bactria, Babylonia, Elam, Media, Parthia, Assyria, and Egypt, which were suppressed with the aid of his co-conspirators. Following this, Darius I led several military expeditions to complete the annexation of Egypt and incorporate much of Central Asia and the Indus Valley into the Persian Empire. Number 3. Bardia, R. 522 BC. The son of Cyrus and brother of Cambyses II, Bardia remains one of the most controversial kings of Persia. On his deathbed, Cyrus made Bardia satrap of the eastern provinces, while Cambyses II became king. According to later sources, shortly before his own death, Cambyses II had Bardia executed out of jealousy but kept it secret. While Cambyses was still away in Egypt, Bardia, or a Median magi named Gamata pretending to be Bardia, began a revolt in Media which soon spread to other parts of the empire. Since Cambyses II had been a despot, and this Bardia promised to remit all taxes for 3 years, he was greeted with open arms. Number 2. Cambyses II, R. 530-522 BC. Cambyses II was the eldest son of Cyrus and his beloved wife Cassandane. After the conquest of Babylon in 539 BC, Cambyses was appointed governor of northern Babylonia, a position he held for 9 months before being dismissed for unknown reasons. He later participated in Cyrus' ill-fated expedition against the Massagetae, but was sent home before his father's death. As king of Persia, Cambyses soon came into conflict with Egypt, the last great power in the Near East. Cambyses II at first worked to isolate Egypt from its allies in Greece and Caria, as well as seizing Cyprus, which served as an important Egyptian base. Number 1. Cyrus the Great, R. 550-530 BC. Founder of the Achaemenid Empire, much of Cyrus' life is shrouded by myth and legend. He was the son of the king of the Persians and the grandson of the king of the Median Empire. Following the death of his father, he revolted against the Medes and was able to overthrow them. This led Cyrus down the path of a conqueror, and he embarked on a series of campaigns that saw Lydia, western Anatolia, Elam, Babylonia, and much of Central Asia added to his domain. As king of Persia, Cyrus now ruled over the largest empire the world had ever seen. What do you think of our list? Which of the king you liked the most? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.